Welcome to the viewers for the lecture in the subject Reinforced Concrete Structures. And in RCC design, in the last lecture, lecture number 158, we have introduced the design of underground water tanks, underground rectangular water tanks. So in which we have discussed how to design the side walls of a rectangular water tank when the longer plan dimension by shorter plan dimension is less than 2. When capital L by small l is less than 2, we have to design all the four walls, side walls, as horizontal continuous slab. And those things we have discussed in the lecture, right? And then we have discussed the case of a tank when capital L by small l more than or equal to 2. When the longer plan dimension by shorter plan dimension is more than 2, we know that we have to design the longer walls as vertical cantilevers, cantilevering for the whole height. And also we have discussed how to design when it is subjected to water pressure, when it is subjected to earth pressure from outside, all those things. That we are, now we will not repeat, we will just discuss along with the numerical example. Similarly, short wall, the bottom h by 4 or 1 meter, whichever is more, we know it behaves as a vertical cantilever. Above 1 meter, the short wall will behave as if it is fixed to the long walls. So that's what you have discussed, and the reinforced details, where you have to provide, in what direction you have to provide, all those things we have discussed. Suppose if you have seen lecture number 158, this lecture will be more clear. So almost it is a prerequisite for going through the lecture number 159, right? So assuming that the viewers have already gone through lecture number 158, let me take up today's lecture, lecture number 159, right? Now we'll take up a numerical example. So design an underground water tank, 5 meters by 12 meters by 3.5 meters height. The subsoil consists of sand having angle of repose of 30 degrees and a saturated unit weight of 17 kilonewton per meter cube. The water table is likely to rise up to the ground level. Use M25 concrete and HYSD bars. For water tanks, we know we have to use a minimum of M25 grade of concrete, right? And take a unit weight of water as 9.81 kilonewton per meter cube. That is a unit weight of water, right? Now, so the size of the tank is 12 by 5 meters plan dimension. Therefore, 12 by 5 is more than 2.4. Therefore, it comes under the second category, that is longer wall will behave as vertical cantilevers, and the shorter wall, bottom 1 meter will act as a cantilever, above 1 meter it will act as a slab fixed between the long walls, right? Now, what are the components that are to be designed in the case of an underground rectangular water tank? So we have designed the long walls, short walls, because their behaviors are different, then roof slab and base slab. These are the four components that have to be designed, right? Now there are a number of conditions. Now we will design for the two critical conditions. One is tank full and no air pressure from outside. But tank full is common, but no air pressure from outside, as we discussed in the earlier lecture, will come only once in a lifetime. Only very rare cases, the client will like to check the tank for leakage. Only in that case. Otherwise, there will be, the tank will never be without backfill outside. Anyway, it is a critical condition. Therefore, we will design for the first case, tank full and no air pressure from outside, which is only once in a lifetime. But we will do it because it is a critical condition. The second one is tank empty and full pressure due to saturated soil. Because this is quite common, because very often we will be cleaning the tank empty, there are a lot of chances. So this is a practical case, right? So tank empty, full earth pressure due to saturated earth fill. Then the base slab will be designed for uplift pressure. When the backfill, when the water is not likely to rise up to the ground level, there will be no problem. Nominal thickness and nominal reinforcement will be enough for the base slab. But because it is subjected to saturated soil and the water pressure is likely to rise up to the ground level, then naturally there will be uplift pressure. The water will try to reach the ground level. When the water around the tank is at ground level, the water below the tank will also be trying to come to the ground level. So it will be subjected to uplift pressure. Therefore, the tank is to be designed for flotation. You have to test the tank for flotation. What is the total downward pressure when the tank is empty? What is the upward water pressure? So what is the difference? Whether the tank is likely to float or not, that is a special design in the case of an underground tank, particularly when it is subjected to water pressure. Right. Now coming to, now it is a very lengthy design. Actually here itself it runs for 28 pages. Therefore, I cannot use the board for this problem. So viewers will have to understand my situation, because many viewers want only the board, but still it is a very lengthy design. So if I write on the board and teach, it will take about 5 to 6 hours. Nobody will be patient enough. Therefore, so kindly adjust. So this I have to do it only like this. Now coming to, right, the longer plan dimension by shorter plan dimension is 12 by 5 equal to 2.4, which is more than 2. So when the capital L by B ratio is greater than 2, the longer walls will be designed as vertical cantilevers. So this already we have discussed. I think that we need not repeat. Bottom 1 meter will behave as a vertical cantilever as far as the shorter wall is concerned, and the top portion will be designed as a slab supported by the long walls. Or in other words, the above 1 meter, the short wall will be treated as fixed between the long walls. So that we know already, right? Now coming to the design constants, M25 concrete, so sigma CBC equal to 8.5 Newton per mm square, and these values, usual values, that is N equal to sigma ST is 130 for tar steel when it is used in the water tank. Otherwise, it is 230 Newton per mm square. So here, when it is used for water tanks, the allowable stress as per IS 3370 is 130 Newton per mm square. And K equal to 0.498. That is at the bottom it is given. So that is the lever arm, mean first neutral axis, N equal to 0.418D. N equal to 0.408D. The lever arm JD equal to 0.861D. Usual routine calculations. And the moment of resistance equal to 1.53 BD square. So these are the formulas we'll be using in the design. One is point lever arm equal to 0.861D. When we use this formula for designing the reinforcement, so we'll use JD at the bottom. And similarly, moment of resistance, when you design the section, when you find out the thickness, we'll require this formula, 1.53 BD square, right? This the viewers will have to remember. Every time we cannot come back, just right. Now we'll take up the design of the long walls. Now the design of long wall, here the tank is subjected to water pressure as well as earth pressure. So we have to design for both. Therefore, here the first tank empty with the saturated soil from outside. The tank is empty, first case. So here P equal to Ka into gamma into H plus gamma W into H. So this is the soil pressure. This is the water, second one is water pressure. Soil pressure Pa equal to Ka, which is equal to 1 minus sin phi by 1 plus sin phi into gamma into H. And gamma W into H, that is due to the water. Therefore, gamma dash equal to Ka into gamma dash into H. Gamma dash equal to 17 minus 9.81. So that is 7.19 kilonewton per meter cube, or 7190 newton per meter cube. So coming to water, it is 9.81 kilonewton per meter cube. So either we can use 9.81 or simply 10, that is nothing wrong, 10 kilonewton per meter cube. I think in the earlier design we used 10, right? So 9.81 kilonewton per meter cube, right? This is the right. Now coming to the pressure calculation, Ka equal to 1 by 3, gamma dash equal to 7190. So that is due to the soil alone. So this is due to the water alone, gamma W into H. So that value is equal to 42,723.33 newton per square meter. This is the water pressure at the intensity of pressure at the bottom. Right. Now this pressure will be acting at a height of 1/3 H from the bottom, or the bending moment equal to the pressure into, that is this formula, that is this is the intensity of pressure at the bottom, half into the intensity of pressure into the height will give you the total pressure. The total pressure will be acting at a height of 1/3 H from the bottom. So into 3.5 by 3, or as we have discussed earlier, so Ka into gamma, of course here consists of water also, therefore this pressure into h square by 6, right? So this is intensity pressure, half into this into 3.5 will give you the total pressure, will be acting at a height of 1/3 height from the base, therefore the bending moment equal to 87.23 into 10 power 6 newton per millimeter. So this is the side wall, this is the cross section of this longer wall. So this is the pressure. For want of space, I have drawn on the right hand side. Actually, it should come on the left hand side. That is why this arrow. So, air pressure acting from outside. Therefore, we know the tension will occur on the backfill. So, this is the air pressure. So, the tension will occur on this side. So, to understand this, this figure will help you. The figure on the top, when the total pressure is acting from left to right, how it will behave, where tension occurs, that will be explained by this. Therefore, we have to provide the steel in the vertical direction. So actually the vertical steel, we have provided three different levels. So up to this one level, then up to this, then up to this. So three levels we are going to design. So the 100% reinforcement will be provided the bottom, that is a 25mm diameter bar set to 75mm set at the center. So at about 1 meter above, it will be at a spacing of 150mm center to center, and above certain level, it will be provided 300mm center to center. This we will discuss in the design little later. Right. Now coming, we are yet to design the section. So this is the bending moment. Bending moment equal to 87.23 into 10 power 6. Therefore, equating the bending moment to the moment of resistance, D equal to, so square root of M divided by Q into B. D square is, so D is square root of D square is this value. Therefore, that gives 238.77 mm as the wall thickness required for the longer wall. So, provide total thickness of 280 mm. So, the effective depth is equal to 280 minus 35. Minus 35 means, we provide a clear cover of 25 mm Then we use 20 mm diameter. We have proposed to use 20 mm diameter bars. So half the diameter bar will be 10 mm. So 25 plus 10, 35 is the effective cover. Therefore, effect depth is equal to 245 mm for the wall thickness, for the longer wall, right? Now that is about the thickness of the wall. Now, area of steel is equal to usual formula, bending moment by sigma st into jd. So bending moment is this value, sigma st, for when the steel is used in the case of water tanks, it is 130 into jd, as we have found earlier, it is 0.861 into d. D is the effective depth. So this is the area of steel. Now using 25 mm diameter bar, actually originally we have started with the 20 mm. Using 25 mm diameter bar, spacing is equal to 491 into 1000 by 3181. For 25 mm diameter bar at 150 mm center, on the outside wall at the bottom of the longer wall. I think this diagram is not meant for this, because outer side we provided 25 mm diameter bar only. Anyway, we'll just come back to this. Now, cut rail butt of reinforcement. This 25 mm diameter bar is required at the bottom at a spacing of 150 mm center to center. Coming to the top, we can go for cut rail butt of reinforcement, because we have designed this reinforcement for the maximum pressure at the bottom when the value of h is equal to 3.5 meters. So when you go towards the top, h will become less, bending moment will become less, and the steel also will become less. So if AST is the steel at the bottom, AST1 is the steel required, say 50% at some level H1, because we know bending moment is Ka into gamma into h cube by 6. Therefore, H1 cube by H cube, AST at the bottom, H at the bottom, AST1 at some level, H1. So H1 is equal to H into AST, 1 by AST to the power 1 by 3, that is where we can provide 50% of the reinforcement. So AST1 equal to half of AST, that is 1 by 2, alternate bars you are going to provide. Half the bars will be cut rail. So that is equal to 2.78 meter from the top. So height from the base equal to 0.72 meter. Now the bars cannot be curtailed just like that. We have to provide some extra length, namely 12 times the diameter of bar. So above 0.72 meter, you have to extend 12 times the diameter of bar. So that will come to 300 mm or 245. So curtail the bars at 0.72 from the bottom plus 0.3, namely this 12 times the diameter, 1.05 meter from the base. That means for the bottom 1.05 meters, you have to provide the full quota of the bar, above which, that is beyond 1.5 meter from the bottom, you can curtail alternate bars. Therefore, alternate bars. So again, that is for approximately a depth of 2.5 meter. Again, for 2.5 meter, you need not provide the whole bar. So where you can curtail another 50%, namely provide only 25% of the bar. So that curtailment is discussed below. I think let us avoid spending time on this. These things you can do it in normal RCA design, curtailment of reinforcement. We'll just more concentrate more on the concept of design of water tanks. So curtailment, you can, the viewers can learn it. Let us avoid spending time on this. So this is what 25 mm diameter bar at 75 mm centimeter at the bottom, 1.5 meter, not 5 meter from the base, 25 mm at 150 mm centimeter center, and at 1.6 meter from the base, 25 mm diameter bar at 300 mm center to center. This is what is proposed to be provided. Distribution scene. Coming to distribution seal, you have to provide as per 3370, you have to provide 0.24% for the distribution seal. So area to be provided 336, spacing equal to area of 1 bar into 1000 by AST required. So 200 mm. So provide 10 mm diameter bar at 200 mm center center on each face. So this is about the distribution steel. So now we have designed the longer wall only for the air pressure from the outside. So the vertical steel will be provided on the backfill side. We know how the wall behaves on the backfill side in the vertical direction. That is the main steel. That is curtailed at different levels. The distribution steel will be provided in the horizontal direction. That is 10 mm diameter bar at 200 mm center center near each face, because on the other side also we have designed the steel only on the backfill side. Now we are going to provide vertical steel on the other side also for the water pressure that we are going to, that it is yet to be designed, yet to be. So this, that's about the distribution steel. Now direct compression in longer walls. So when it is subjected to air pressure from outside, when there is no water inside, the pressure acting on the shorter wall will cause compression in the longer wall. Air pressure is there all round, right? When you design the longer wall is designed as a vertical cantilever, but there are shorter walls. Air pressure is from all sides, so the pressure on the short wall will act as compression in the long wall. So that also we have discussed. So that is why I repeat, knowledge on the lecture number 158 is very essential. There we have elaborately discussed. Right now, coming to the direct compression, the air pressure acting on the short walls will cause compression on long walls, because the top portion of short wall act as slab supported on long walls. Right. At h equal to 1 meter or h by 4, whichever is more. Here h is 3.5, therefore h by 4 will be less than 1 meter. So we use higher value, namely 1 meter. So more than 1 meter, h by 4, above the base, the pressure is equal to Ka into gamma, h dash, gamma dash into h minus h. So this small height, either h by 4 or 1 meter, whichever is more, so small, because bottom 1 meter will act as a cantilever, as far as the shorter walls are concerned. Only above 1 meter, that is going to behave as a wall supported between the long walls. So that pressure at a level 1 meter above will cause direct compression on the long walls. So that value equal to 30,517 Newton per square meter. Now, so that this is the value in terms of Newton per square meter. So the direct compression developed on long wall is given by, we are going to consider 1 meter depth, 1 meter depth and 5 meters length, because the length of the shorter wall is 5 meters. 5 meters into 1 meter into 3517 into 5 meters into 1 meter by 2. That is equal to 76,292.5 Newton. This is the pressure due to the soil that is transferred from the shorter wall to the longer wall in the form of direct compression. Right. So the wall will be, this will be taken by the distribution steel, or we have to design the steel. Actually, we have provided 0.24%. If at all, if we want, we have to find out T by sigma ST. T is 76,292.5. It is a direct compression. Therefore, the compression divided by sigma ST will give you the area of the steel. So, if the area of steel provided already is more than this value, we can leave it. Otherwise, we have to go for this. So, if at all we want, we can check. This is direct compression. Compression by sigma st will give you the area of steel. Compare this area of steel with that of the minimum steel. If that is more, we can leave it. If this is more, then we have to redesign. Redesign the horizontal steel, only for the horizontal steel, right? So that is about the longer wall due to earth pressure. Longer wall will act as a cantilever, causing tension on the backfill side, and also it will be subjected to compression from the short wall when it is subjected to earth pressure alone. Next, again, now tank full with the water and no earth fill from outside. Backfill is free now. I told it is only one time affair, right? Right. So tank full with the water. Now, when the tank is full with the water, water pressure will be acting from inside. That is gamma W into H. Gamma W is 9810 into 3.5. This is the water pressure. And the bending moment equal to, so this pressure at the bottom, that is half into pressure at the bottom into height, will give you the total pressure. Total pressure is equal to half into intensity at the bottom into H. Into that will be acting at H by 3 from the bottom. So 3.5 by 3. So this is the bending moment. It is gamma into H cube by 6. That's all. Gamma into. Right. So M equal to 70.1. Now, backfill is absent. Water pressure is there from inside. So this will cause tension on the water side. On the water side. And we have to provide again steel in the vertical direction. Now, it is on the water side. It is on the water side. So 70.01 into 10 power 6 will be the bending moment as a cantilever. This is the maximum value causing tension near the water surface. Right. So for this, we provide the steel. Steel equal to bending moment by sigma st into jd is this value. Using 20 ohm diameter bars, spacing is equal to 1000 into 314, area of one bar by A is the required, equal to 122 mm. Actually, this is what we have adopted in calculating the effective cover. Effective cover, we have assumed a 25 mm. Actually, there we have used 25 mm diameter bar, but we have assumed that as 20 mm when we calculated the effective cover and effective depth. Actually, this is the value that has been taken. So, the confusion can just eliminate 20 mm diameter bar and provide 20 mm diameter bar, 120 mm centered at the center at the inside face. So, this is the steel at 120 mm. Again, curtailment 120 mm. Now, this is the water pressure acting from inside. Now, this will give more clarity. So, 20 mm diameter bar, tension will occur on the water side. So, 20 mm diameter 140, 120 mm centered center. After the design for curtailment, it is 20 mm diameter bar and 240 mm centered center. So, this is provided for the bottom 1.05 meter, above which you provide 20 mm diameter bar at 240 mm centered center. And this steel is provided on the water side. Earlier, we have provided the other side, backfill side. So that is why we have, when we designed the distribution seal, provide distribution seal on both faces. So on backfill side and also on the water side. Both side, because both side you are going to provide vertical seal. On the backfill side for the soil pressure. On the water side for the water pressure. Therefore, we will be providing vertical steel as a cantilever on both faces. One for the soil pressure and one for the water pressure. So, this requires a little clear understanding. Design is very interesting. So, 158 plus this will help to understand the design concept very clearly. Right. So, right. Then, this is what I told. At 1 meter above the base, so this is the water pressure acting on the now this is yet to be designed. So what we have discussed earlier, air pressure was acting from outside, it has caused a direct compression in the long wall. Now water pressure is acting from inside, so these are the reactions in the short wall, and this will be acting as tension in the long wall. So we have to be very clear. Earlier we have discussed earth pressure only. So earth pressure has transferred compression from short wall to long wall. When it is subjected to water pressure is acting from inside. So that the 61312.5 is the reaction at the end of the short wall. This reaction at this junction will act as a tension in the long wall. Tension. Previously compression, now tension. So this is about the, and this pressure 9810 into 3.5 minus 1, it is at a level 1 meter above the base. Now, 1 meter above the base, it is 9810 into 3.5 minus 1. At the bottom, it is 9810 into 3.5. Why we are calculating the pressure at a level 1 meter above the base? As far as the short wall is concerned, bottom 1 meter will act as a cantilever. Only above 1 meter, that will act as a slab fixed between the long walls that will transfer compression due to air pressure or tension due to water pressure from the shorter wall to the longer wall. Right. Now again curtailment. Curtailment, but actually we are still designing only the longer wall ASK equal to 2557. We have not discussed the curtailment. Of course curtailment you can understand, so that we will not spend more time on this. So this already we have discussed. Therefore at base provide 20 mm diameter bar at 120 mm centers, at 1.05 meter above the base provide 20 mm diameter bar at 240 mm center. This is due to the, this is the main reinforcement on the long wall due to water pressure from inside and no air pressure from outside. So right, again here we know the long wall will be subjected to tension when it is subjected to water pressure from inside. Just now we have discussed through the sketch. So this is the tension is 61312.5. Area steel required equal to tension divided by sigma st, T divided by sigma st. This is the tension divided by sigma st is 130, therefore 472 mm square. The ASD provided in the horizontal direction is 672 mm square, because we have to check, because this is the steel required for the pull that is transferred due to the water pressure from short wall to long wall. That requires 672 mm square. Already we have provided distribution steel. That distribution steel is 672 mm square. Therefore, the steel required for this tension has been already provided in the form of distribution steel, which is more than this value. Therefore, this will take care of this pull also. So, when you design the steel that is required for the direct compression or direct tension, you have to compare this value with that of the distribution steel. If the steel provided as distribution steel is more than this, then we can leave it. Otherwise, we have to redesign. For any reason, the wall should not go unsafe. Right? Hence, so the distribution steel itself will take care of the direct tension. Right. Now, here, this is just to show the slab fixed between the long wall. Above 1 meter, it will act as a slab fixed between the long walls. At the bottom 1 meter, it will act as a cantilever. Coming to the pressure, this is the pressure at the bottom. Pressure at the bottom. It is just for example, it is given as W. And above 1 meter, it is W into H minus 1. So, and when we design the bottom 1 meter for the cantilever effect, secondary effect, we have to consider the total height for the calculation of pressure. The calculation of the total pressure is equal to W into H. So W, just for example, W into H, right? Now this is W into H minus 1, W into H minus 1, right? However, for the bottom 1 meter cantilevering portion, this pressure diagram is to be considered. In this pressure distribution also, we have to take the total maximum pressure at the bottom, whereas in this pressure diagram, this trapezium pressure distribution diagram, we have to take zero value at the top. So the this triangular part of the pressure diagram is to be considered for the bottom 1 meter height and not the trapezium part. So what is shown here for the bottom 1 meter, this is the pressure diagram that is to be considered for the bending moment at the, for the bottom 1 meter, because we should not just become confused with that of the trapezium pressure diagram. So as per the researchers earlier, it is found that triangular pressure diagram alone, but when you find out the pressure at the bottom, you have to consider the total height. Right. So this is the diagram that is to be considered for the bottom, because when we calculate, we will consider 1 meter height into 1 by 3 as the center of gravity, all those things. So there, one should not get confused. Right. Because when we check the calculation, this confusion will be there for everyone. So this has to be understood. Right. Now, that completes the design of the long wall. So far, we have designed only the long wall due to air pressure, then compression transfer from short wall to long wall, then water pressure from inside, then tension that is transferred from short wall to long wall. So we have designed only one wall so far, both for soil pressure as well as water pressure. Right. Now, next is set of the design of short wall. Now, coming to the design of short wall, again two cases. Tank empty with the pressure of saturated soil from outside. Right. Top portion, actually bottom portion will act as a cantilever, while the remaining 2.5 meters acts as a slab between the long walls. So at H equal to 1 meter or more than H by 4 above the base of the soil, the pressure is equal to the pressure at a level 1 meter above the base equal to this value. This small h equal to 1 meter, you can understand, the viewers can understand. So the pressure at that level is 30157. I think it is given in the diagram also. So this is the pressure at a level 1 meter above the base. So above 1 meter base, we know it is treated as a slab fixed between the long walls. So at the supports, the moment equal to PL square by 12. At the center, it is PL square by 24. So PL square by 12 equal to this 30517 into 5 square by 12. So this is the pressure. Bending moment. This is the bending moment. And at the center, it is simply PA into L square by 24, or this is the positive bending moment, WL square by 8, minus the fixed end moment, PL square by 12. WL square by 8 minus WL square by 12 will be equal to WL square by 24. So one need not fear about these formulas. Support moment, WL square by 12. At the moment, center, the positive moment is WL square by 8, subtracting the negative moment, WL square by 12, this is WL square by 24. Or PA into L square by 24 will directly give you this value. So on seeing the formulas, one need not get confused. I'll show that diagram also subsequently. So this is the bending moment causing tension on the outside. This is the bending moment causing tension on the inside. because this is due to the soil pressure. So soil pressure acting from outside, therefore at the center this will cause tension on the inside. And that supports, we just calculate the steel requirement. So AST equal to bending moment. Bending moment is 63,577. So for which the steel is this value. Using 20 mm diameter bar, spacing equal to 20 mm diameter bar at 120 mm center to center at the outer face at 2.5 meter below the top, because bottom 1 meter cantilever. So this is going to be provided in the horizontal direction. The steel will be provided in the horizontal, above 1 meter. The steel for the short wall will be in the horizontal direction. Of course, this number may not be so clear. So these diagrams will give a clear picture how it will behave when it is subjected to water pressure from inside. What is the support moment? What is the moment at the center? Due to this soil pressure from outside, where tension occurs, so the tension at the midspan will be, the bending moment, the steel will be in the horizontal direction on the inner side. The steel at the supports will be on the soil side. Steel will be in the horizontal direction. Whether we have to provide on the inner side or outer side. So due to the soil pressure from outside, the steel will be on the inside in the horizontal direction at the center. At the supports, it is on the soil side. Same thing later we will discuss when it is subjected to water pressure from inside. At the center, the steel will be provided away from the water side, that is on the backfill side. Now this steel will be provided on the inner face. So that one has to clearly understand, right? Now coming to this steel will be provided on the inside. See here, this will make things clear. That is in the midspan and at the ends. This is the cross section of the shorter wall. If we see only the numbers, will not understand. So these diagrams will help you to understand, because the final diagram will be consisting of lot of lines and the dots. There we cannot understand everything. So if these things are understood step by step, then understanding the final diagram will not be difficult. For what quantity we are providing steel in the horizontal direction, then for what moment you have to provide steel in the vertical direction, why you have to provide outside, why you have to provide inside, why the steel is provided both outside and both inside, these things are to be clearly understood. Otherwise, that design will be tough. It is not at all tough, right? So that is why so many illustrative sketches, how it behaves and so on, right? So near the that is the corners, the steel will be on the outer side. So this is the plan. What is shown here is the plan of the time. So when you see the cross section, the steel will be provided on the backfill side. So this is due to the soil pressure. The same thing we are going to discuss. There is water pressure from inside, there will be no soil pressure. In that case, it will be the reverse. That is, this steel will be provided on the outer side, and the corners, this steel will be provided on the inner side. So what is provided for soil pressure, what is provided for water pressure? One has to be very clear. Design is not at all difficult. If you simply read the numbers, it will be confusing. Right. Now this is the soil pressure. Once again, one more diagram. This is to show the behavior of the bottom 1 meter. Bottom 1 meter will be acting as a cantilever. Bottom 1 meter, the pressure at the bottom here is this value is, it will be calculation will be available below this page. So this is the pressure. So we have to consider only the triangular part of the diagram, as I told earlier. So we have to, so actually it will be a trapezium. It will be a trapezium like this. It's a trapezium. For the calculation of the pressure at the bottom, we have to take the total height, 3.5 meters. But we have to take only the triangular part of the pressure diagram for the calculation of bending moment. So at the top, we have to assume the value as zero, as shown here. So this triangle is shown. So actually, when you look at this diagram, it will be a trapezium. That should not be taken for the calculation of bending moment. So that is what is shown here. These diagrams, one has to be familiar, right? So this is the diagram. This is the cantilevering part. This is soil pressure from outside. Therefore, the tension will be on the outer face. So for which you have to provide steel on the outer face, 20 mm diameter, a 250 mm center to center. Again, when it is subjected to water pressure from inside, when there is no soil from outside, then this bar will be provided on the water side. On the water side, the pressure, now here it is from outer side to water. Now from water to outside, so for which you provide steel on the opposite direction. These things one has to understand, right? So this is the steel spacing, and these things one can easily understand. This will just skip. Bottom 1 meter will behave or bend or act as a cantilever. This is the pressure, 42,723. So this is what we have discussed here, 42,723.33. This will cause tension on the backfill side, and for which you provide steel ...20 mm diameter bar, or 250 mm center to center. 20 mm diameter, 257. So this is what is shown here as 20 mm diameter bar and 250 mm center to center. So these calculations one can easily understand. At different places we have shown the diagram only for making the viewers to understand. So this is the pressure at the bottom. After some steps, we will take 3517. 3517 is the pressure at a level 1 meter above the base. So this 3517 will be used for the calculation of bending moment in the slab at 1 meter above the base. Because above 1 meter, it will act as a slab fixed between the long walls. For that, we will just use 3517. 3517, right. Now, before that, design direct compression in short walls. Direct compression in short wall. So now we are designing the short wall. The short wall will receive compression from the long wall. As far as the compression or tension is concerned, entire length of short wall will transfer the load to the long wall. Either in the calculation of direct compression or direct tension, the entire length of the short wall will transfer the force to the long wall. Whereas, when you consider the force transfer from long wall to short wall, the entire length of the long wall will not transfer the force. Only 1 meter length at the ends, I think from the, that also diagram is available, only 1 meter length of the wall at the ends will transfer the load to the short wall. Therefore, it will not be the pressure into 12 by 2. It is only 1 meter. It's only 1 meter. See here. Though the long walls bend as cantilever, it is observed that the end 1 meter width of long wall contributes to push in short walls due to the earth pressure. So PBC, that is equal to PA into, don't worry about the notations, right, into 1, PA into 1. The pressure at level 1 meter above the base is 3517, just now we have seen, into only 1 meter length. So this is the pull, not pull, this is the compression, because now we are discussing only the earth pressure. earth pressure will be acting from outside. So 1 meter length of the wall will transfer the force to the short wall as compression. So this is the compression. This is a very small value, right? So this is one value. So as far as short wall is concerned, right, we have considered the bending moment as well as the compression, right? Now tank with the full with water, tank full with water and no earth fill outside, tank full with water. Now we have discussed about the earth pressure from outside. Now tank is full with water and no earth fill outside, therefore the bottom 1 meter again as a cantilever will be the pressure at 1 meter above the base is W into h minus 1 water pressure. Water pressure from inside at 1 meter above it is 24,525, right? Above 1 meter it will be a slab fixed between the long walls. So WL square by 12 at the corners, WL square by 20, this is at the center, this is at the corners, it is WL square by 12 support moment, WL square by 12 at the center, it is WL square by 24, which is WL square by 8 minus WL square by 12, WL square by 24. Now, already we have discussed where this will cause tension. So that the corners, this will cause tension on the inside, and at the center, this water pressure will cause tension on the outside. Just reverse to what you have studied earlier, right? So direct tension in short wall, again, direct tension in short wall. When it is subjected to internal water pressure, then from the long wall, short wall will receive tension. So that will be clear through this figure. Now, when it is subjected to W into H minus 1, that is 1 meter above, where tension occurs, where we have to provide the steel. This is illustrated through this sketch. This is the steel for a level 1 meter above the base, steel on the outer side, this is steel on the inner side. This is the plan of the shorter wall 1 meter above the base, because at a time put together if you see the reinforcement, it will be little congested, so better, right. So this is the water pressure, like water pressure W into H minus 1, H minus 1 only into 1 meter length. So 9810 into 2.5 into only 1 meter length of long wall will transfer the pull to the short wall. So 24,525. So effective depth is equal to D. Now this pull or push will cause a bending moment, which will cause a reduction in the bending moment. That is, we have to find out what is known as resultant bending moment. Resultant bending moment is equal to m minus t into x. M is the bending moment, minus t is the tension or compression, tension into x. X means it is a distance between the center of the wall thickness and the center of gravity of the reinforcement, because this pull or compression will act at the center of the wall. So the distance between the center of the wall and the center of the reinforcement, that is half the thickness minus the effective cover, thickness minus effective cover. So, or in other words, it is the effective depth minus half the thickness. So that is what is calculated as 231. 231 is the effective depth minus half the thickness of the wall, 140, 280 by 140, 91 mm. So the distance between the center of gravity of the reinforcement and the center of the wall thickness is x. So the tension or compression will cause a reduction in the bending moment equal to the tension or compression into the value of x. So that is the calculation. So from which you find out the resultant bending moment. So this m minus pb into x. Or simply you can say t into x or c into x if it is tension, it is T. If it is compression, it is C. The compression or tension transfer from one wall to the other wall, that will cause a reduction in the bending moment, whose value equal to the tension into x, m minus t in dx or m minus c in dx is a resultant bending moment. Now we know what is x. So if we have to provide steel for the resultant bending moment, then steel for the pull or compression, steel for the pull, or which is a direct value, that is T by sigma st or C by sigma st. So these two are to be added, and that combined steel is to be provided. Combined steel is to be provided. M minus Tx. So inner face as well as outer face. So the resultant bending moment you have to find out, for which you have to provide the steel. AST1, AST2, find out the total AST, that we have to provide. So I provide 20 mm diameter bars at 150 mm center to center on the inner face. Coming to the outer face, middle of the short wall, because we are designing for the water pressure. So water pressure, middle of the short wall, it will cause tension on the outer side, that is on the backfill side, you know, just now we have seen one figure. Therefore, this is MC minus PB in dx, that is the bending moment. This is the PL square by 24 value, PL square by 24 minus the compression into x by, so this is the resultant bending moment, by sigma st into gd, this value. So for this, we provide the steel on the outer side, provide 20 mm diameter bar at 250 mm center to center at the outside face. This is the reinforcement required for the water pressure. This will be provided near the water side at the corners, outside the water face at the mid span. So hence provide this value. So bottom portion, again bottom portion cantilever, bottom 1 meter will bend as a cantilever. So gamma h, water pressure, so 9810 into 3.5, and we have to consider only the triangular pressure diagram. Maximum value is 34355, at the top it is 0, we know, yeah, 0. So for which you find out the bending moment, you find out the steel, and you check with the minimum steel, because you have provided the minimum reinforcement. So it contains a number of terms. So short wall, long wall, water pressure, air pressure, etc. So still we have to complete the top slab and bottom slab. That will require about half an hour. So we will just stop with this and continue in the next lecture. Now this is 159. In 160, we will continue the rest of the design, because if I continue for 1.5 hours, it will be very boring. But the viewers want to learn full design of an underground tank, they have to become familiar with 158, 159 and also 160, which is yet to be delivered. So therefore, let me stop this lecture with this, and thank you for your patience. We will continue this design in the next lecture. Thank you.